Hello friends, welcome to Tiny Sea Study. In this video, we are going to discuss English pedagogy MCQs. These questions are very important for upcoming CTET and TET examinations. This is our second session. If you are interested, you can watch our first session. So let's the first question. There are 44 sounds in English. Out of these, how many sounds are vowels and how many are consonants respectively? A. 20, 24. B. 5, 39. C. 22 and 22. D 10 34. So right answer will be A. It is 20 and 24. There are 44 sounds in English and 5 vowels have 20 different sounds and consonant has 24 sounds. Please remember, vowel has 20 sounds and consonant has 24 sounds. Let's move on to the next question. The study of words and their meaning is known as semantics, linguistics, phonetics, syntax. The study of words and their meaning is known as semantics. The study of words and their meaning is known as semantics. A strong understanding of words help us to know where to use words in a sentence. Please remember. So let's move on to the next question. Intensive reading is aimed at helping the learners read a text for information, improving reading skill, accuracy, pleasure only. So right answer will be it is for accuracy. Intensive reading involves learner reading in detail with specific learning aims and tasks. Intensive reading helps the learner to develop accuracy. The more one reads, the more accurate he becomes. So let's do the next question. Grammar should be taught by giving a clear explanations, enabling practice in context, asking students to learn rules, making learners to written assignments. So here right answer will be B, enabling practice in context. Let's move on to the next question. TBLT in second language teaching is task-based language training, taskbook language teaching, tool-based language training, task-based language teaching. So right answer will be D, task-based language teaching. It is also known as task-based instruction that focus on the use of authentic language and asking students to do meaningful task using target language. Children can best learn a language when they having a good textbook, a proficient language teacher, inhibition, motivation. So right answer will be it is motivation. Motivation can help a child learn a language in a best way. On the other hand, inhibition provides a hindrance and makes a child self-conscious and unable to act in a relaxed and natural way. So right answer will be motivation. So let's see the next question. The second language should be taught through using the target language as much as it is possible, learner's background and talent, mother tongue and translation, grammar rules and language. So here right answer will be A, using the target language as much as it is possible. So let's see the next question. When learners have diverse linguistic backgrounds, the teacher should start the class with brainstorming sessions, form groups according with their linguistic background, ascertain their learning style, use multilingual approach. So right answer will be D, use multilingual approach. Multilingualism is the ability of a individual or a speaker to communicate effectively in three or more languages. So let's see the next question. A child in class 2 will initially learn the language in the most effective manner through which one of given methods. A. Playway method. B. Practice and drill. C. Imitation. D. All of the above. So here right answer will be D, all of the above. Question number 25. Process writing approach could be described as top-down approach, bottom-up approach, horizontal approach, vertical approach. So here right answer will be B, bottom-up approach. Bottom-up approach starts with the small details like vocabulary, words, or step-by-step process of solving like an algorithm. Let's see the next question. Correct speech habits can be effectively developed through quizzes, dictation, pronunciation practice, vocabulary practice. So correct speech habits can be effectively developed through, it is a C, pronunciation practice. Let's see the next question. The best way to develop a child's vocabulary at the initial stage is to leave the child alone with storybooks, make him to go to school at a very young age, engaging in talks with the child and reading out loud. D. Show the child various programs on TV. Here, right answer will be C. Engaging in talks with the child and reading out aloud. So let's move on to the next question. Which one of the following is not true about the status of English language across the world? English as a native language, English as a heritage language, English as a foreign language, English as a second language. Here right answer will be B, English as a heritage language. So let's move on to the next question. For a first generation learners, learning second language English can be easy if the learner lives in a home environment, if learner is highly motivated, if learner gets an environment where second language is spoken. D, both B and C. So here right answer will be D, both B and C, and it is if learner is highly motivated and if learner gets an environment where second language only is spoken. So let's see the next question. Alvira, an English teacher, describe a scene and ask the learner to draw what they have heard. This is a picture composition, musical dictation, picture dictation, picture story. Here right answer will be picture dictation. Picture dictation. In picture dictation, children have to draw the picture according to text they are listening to. So thank you very much. Thanks for watching. If you interested in our session, you can subscribe our channel. Have a great day.